You mentioned on your website, Broad Street Hockey, that you guys have been critical of the moves they've made. They've added 8 players, including rookies, 3 rookies, but they've also added 72-year-old Jaromir Jagr. He's actually older than the number 68 that he wears on his back. He got his 1,600th career point last night in a Flyers uniform that led to the Flyers' 2-1 win. Now, Jagr, of course, came back from 3 years in exile in Siberia, actually played in Russia for 3 years. But again, he's an older guy. Have you guys, I have not read your articles about Jagr, so I have 2 questions. One, have you been overly critical of this move, and how do you feel about him in a Flyers uniform this year?
Well, it's definitely really, really strange that he's in a Flyers uniform. Haven't gotten used to it yet. You know, I guess it's only been about 5 games if you take into consideration the preseason, but still not used to it yet. It's going to take a while to get used to, but you know what? As soon as he scores a goal for the Flyers against the Penguins, it's going to be awesome. So, you know, we'll get used to it pretty quickly. And if he plays like he does, if the chemistry with Claude Giroux keeps up, it's going to be fun. But, you know, we haven't been critical of the move at all, because the way I look at it personally is he basically replaces Ville Leino. And Ville Leino last year was a good piece for the Flyers, but overall, he only scored about, I think he scored 52 points or 54 points or something last year, somewhere in the low 50s. And, you know, he got $4 million from the Sabres this offseason. And that's just crazy for a player that's not going to put up 50 points. It's really only a complimentary piece on your team. And, you know, the Flyers didn't want to give him that money, and instead they decided to give 3.3 to Jaromir Jagr. And, you know, if the chemistry with Giroux is any indication, you know, we already had a point last night. He had several, I think he had 4 goals in the preseason, 2 assists. You know, if that keeps up, which, you know, it's a big question mark if that can keep up, because he is, as you said, 72 years old. If that can keep up, then, you know, there's no reason to think he can't score 60 points.
Well, I mean, so to
3 years ago with the Rangers, he scored 70-something. So, I mean, it is possible.
Well, so to your point, he doesn't have what he has to live up to. The expectations aren't that high, so he should do a good job. I mean, people on Twitter talking about Jagr last night, everybody going from congratulating him to making some jokes like this one that says, Jagr looks old. The gray and sexy look just doesn't work for him. And then other people congratulating him on his 1,600th point. I mean, I look at it, to your point, about for the money that they would have spent, why not take a flyer, pun intended, on a guy like Jagr? I mean, the Bruins did that a couple of years ago with Paul Coffey. Coffey couldn't stay healthy. He wasn't the same player. It turned out to be not a great move in the end, but he had his moments. If Jagr stays healthy, I mean, again, this is a guy, depending on how much gas he has left in the tank, could be an X factor, like what Mark Recchi was with the Bruins for a couple of years. Completely different players, but that would be the hope, right?
Yeah, certainly. And you know what? Jagr has never really had a major injury in his career, as far as I know. So, you know what? He is an animal. He goes back to the training facility every single night. After the team practices in the morning, he goes back at like 7-8 o'clock at night and practices by himself. Ilya Bryzgalov tweeted, I guess it was last week or 2 weeks ago, that he found Jaromir Jagr at the training facility at midnight, just working out by himself on the ice. It's just, I mean, he's a great example for the young players that the Flyers do have in that regard. You know what? He is going over very well so far. And if this keeps up, and, you know, I don't think there's any reason to think, I mean, yeah, he's Jaromir Jagr, he has a reputation, but I don't think there's any reason to think that won't keep up. You know, he didn't come back to the NHL to make a fool out of himself. The only reason, I mean, he obviously wouldn't do it for the money. He's fine in that regard now. You know, the only reason he's back in the NHL is because he thinks he can still play.